guys. What are you guys doing coming around the garage door? Let's go through the front. Let me give you guys an updated tour of the house.
Hey, yo, what is going on, guys? Doug Sensenmaier in here. I hope you guys are having a great, great day. I am so excited because today we're doing another house tour video, baby. Just for that sheer fact alone, let's see how many likes we could smash on this video. I'm not gonna give you guys a number. I just want you guys to go ahead. If you're watching this, click the like button. Don't say anything, just click it. Keep watching the video, keep on enjoying, because today is really special. It's not just any normal house tour video. Today, the house has been sheetrocked. The home is coming together. It is closer and closer and closer to a reality, and we're finally gonna see what the rooms of the house are gonna look like, so I am so excited. And if you guys are wondering why I'm whispering, is because you're not sleeping in the other room, so yeah. Mimi, let's go, baby. Let's go. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Stretch, stretch, stretch. Let's go, baby, come on. We're gonna go see the house. We're gonna go see the house, baby. You wanna go? Yeah, let's go, baby, come on. God, she is so cute. Watch, she's gonna start barking right now. Let's go, Mimi. Oh. What did I say, guys? She's so cute. Mimi. Mimi. Let's go, baby. Let's go. Aww. What's up, Dad?
What's up?
So what are we doing today?
Well, we just ate, so that was good.
Yes, guys. We do this tradition every time. As you guys know, Oakeny Diner in Islip, we get the chocolate chip pancakes. My dad gets...
Two eggs over easy, bacon or sausage, rye toast.
And then we
and a glass of milk, because one day I want to be big and strong just like my son.
If I have a dollar for every time I hear my dad say that, every time we go to a restaurant, I would probably be able to pay for this house in cash, Dad. We're going over to the house now, and it's all sheetrocked, it's all done. And I did want to say one thing before we did get over there, Dad. The last time when we made a house video, as we're in the car over to the house, I said if we broke 50,000 likes on the video that you had to shave your head bald, because that would add up to 100,000 likes between the two videos. Well, we broke like 44,000 or something like that. So we're only 6,000 off. If we get those last 6,000 likes on this video.
But that's not the contract I signed. I signed the contract saying 100,000 subs on my channel. So guys, help me out. I'll do it. Don't worry about it. I'll do it. We'll do it in two steps. We'll do half on his channel. Well, I'll do half my head, because we only got halfway with his help, and then the final we'll do on my channel. So I'll walk around for half a day with half a head.
Well, we got 94,000 likes in total, which means that we're gonna shave off 94% of your head. So we'll leave
negative.
One little strand right here.
A little one over the top coming down.
Make everything just bald.
I look like a Spanish monk.
Hey, what's up, guys? What are you guys doing coming around the garage door? Let's go through the front. Let me give you guys an updated tour of the house. So, everything's coming along really nice. I'm gonna take the camera from you, Dad. Everything's coming along really nice right now. The driveway is finished, as you guys saw last time. When we came here last time, we only showed you guys the outside of the house and how the driveway, how the brick was done, how the siding was done. Now, all the sheetrock is done. They're spackling, and then they're gonna be painting and moving forward with the house. It's gonna take at least another month or so, but it's coming along. It's moving really fast, and this is what it looks like from the front. And now, we're gonna go inside. So, we're just gonna walk inside this door. Dad, are you excited?
Yes.
I just wanna bring you along with me, so I'm not talking to myself. I wanna have someone else to talk to you while we do this, but. All right, guys, here we go. We walk inside, and the house is really coming along. The dining room, the upstairs. This is gonna be like a formal sitting room. The plan that we have for this room, this is like where you have guests come over that you don't really know too well, or just like if you want people to come in really quick, you just have them come over here. You say, hey, sit down over here. I probably won't put a TV on this wall or anything, but we'll have a bunch of furniture in here just for people to sit down and have a place to be comfortable. Say like I'm getting ready, I'm about to go out. I'll be like, all right, guys, just sit over here and I'll be out in a second. So here we go. I'm just gonna walk around and let you guys see it and make your own opinions on it. Dad.
Yeah.
Help me out here. Say something. Anything.
What's up, man?
How you doing?
Good.
You had a good morning?
Good morning. Good breakfast.
What's your favorite room in the house?
The one with the biggest TV. Probably the living room.
So let's go over to the living room now, guys. First, I'll show you this bathroom really quick. As you guys can see, the walls are all on now. The last time I did one of these inside house tours, there's just like wooden sticks everywhere. But the walls are on. This is gonna be like a maid's quarters or just like a guest room. I don't know what I would exactly call this, but as you guys see, the closet got some purple walls over here in the bathroom because I love purple. I'm joking, by the way. I'm just trolling. Dad!
Yeah?
So help me out. I have a big important question to ask you here.
What is it?
Where should the TV go in the living room?
All right, I think it should go on this wall because you can go up to 100-inch then. And then if you have it on this wall, you'll be able to see it through the whole house. Like if you're in the kitchen working, you can turn it on there. If you're sitting at your center island there, you can watch it. If you're sitting at the little kitchen table here, you can watch it. But I see the other point of view where if you put it over the fireplace, your eye pretty much directly goes to over the fireplace anyway, which Vinny brought up. It is nice. I guess, yeah, I'd probably put it over the fireplace. That's probably where it's going to work best for a big TV. But the only thing is you're limited to an 85-inch probably.
So 85-inch is still a really big TV.
It certainly is.
What do you guys think we should do? Comment and let me know your opinions. I'm going to read a lot of the comments. This wall screams TV. This fireplace screams TV. This would be a little bit better just because when you're eating breakfast or you're doing something in the kitchen, and we're going to walk over to the kitchen now, by the way, guys. You'd be able to see the TV a lot better as opposed if you were to be looking at it over there. So, I want to know what you guys think.
But then again, you could always get another smaller TV and just put it on the wall there.
Well,
like 40 inches or something, put it right here.
Well, we got to see what the kitchen's going to look like when it's finished. Like, what if we have appliances and stuff going up here?
Well, then you can put it there.
We don't need to put a TV in like every single square foot of the house, though.
Well, if it was my house, it would.
Yeah, my dad's obsessed.
How many bathrooms you got?
How many bathrooms are in this house?
Four.
Four bathrooms. So one of them is over here. No, there's more than four bathrooms, isn't there? Okay, so there's one here.
Two half baths.
There's one there. There's one in the master bathroom. And there's one over there. Okay, so right now, there's still sheetrocking and there's still, or spackling, I'm sorry. The spackling over here. I'm going to show you guys this area of the house. We're going to go towards the upstairs now because this, I'm going to show you guys the last room and save the last for best. But this is sick, okay? This is really coming along and I'm really excited. And Vinny made my day. He told me that this whole house is going to have surround sound system built in. I don't know what the brand was, the product of it, but there's going to be surround sound for the entire house. Like from the living room to that sitting room I showed you guys, to the kitchen, to the dining room, to my master bedroom over here. Everything's gonna have surround sound, and that made me super happy. We're gonna take you guys over to these two guest rooms over here. So, like I said, if you guys like the video, you're able to stay in one of these guest rooms. If you guys are not obliged to sharing a bathroom, we have a Jack and Jill bathroom here. So, if two of you guys wanna stay, one room here for you, you got a window with a street view, and a closet over here. Then you have your bathroom, which is a Jack and Jill, which means there's two for one and there's no like door, there's just this one door here, kind of like how the FaZe house has it. There's gonna be one sink here, another sink here, it's gonna go out from about here to over here, mirrors and lights up here, and then this is gonna be sort of like a shower, bathroom area, and then this connects to the other room, just like how, if you guys seen the FaZe house tour videos, that's exactly how this is to the other room. This is actually one of my favorite rooms in the house. I probably won't be spending too much time here. This will be more of a guest room for people who come over, whether it's my family, other YouTubers, Yannette's family, whoever it is. I'm gonna have plenty of room, plenty of space for people to come and feel at home. That's my goal of this house. For anyone who comes over here, I want them to make it feel like it's their own home, and I want them to make it feel like it's a vacation spot. That's been my dream, and it's finally coming true thanks to you guys. Here's the backyard. Once it focuses, it goes all the way out to the back. It's still in its early stages. We still have to put landscaping out. We have to come out with our designs that we want for the backyard, the in-ground pool, the hot tub, the pool house. We still haven't figured all that out yet. That's gonna be coming only in the next couple of months. And like I said, I'm gonna give you guys updates along the way. But we're gonna make our way over, not to the master bedroom yet. We're gonna go over to this special room. We don't know what we're gonna do with this one yet. This is probably the biggest guest room in the house. As you see, there's a huge closet over here. And then you have a bathroom in here. What's up, man?
Hi,
how you doing?
Good.
Everyone's working hard on this place. It's so amazing to see it all coming together. We don't know what we wanna do. I'm gonna come back to this room in a second, but I wanna show you guys the master bedroom first. And I want you guys to also help me out with another thing that we have a problem with, but this is the master bedroom here. As you see now, you have the ceiling, you have all the electrical wires in there. We're gonna put a TV on this wall. We're gonna have a bed sitting out all over here. We're gonna have some nightstands on each side of the bed. Maybe a mirror over here and like another stand or a table. Have that fireplace that's in my room right now here with the TV just in the center. And we make our way over to, which way are we going to go? Left or right, left or right? We're gonna go right to the master bathroom. So the plan for this is there's gonna be a toilet over here. We're gonna have a big bathtub here, looking out at this view of this cul-de-sac. Like I said, there's still gonna be other homes being made, there's still gonna be landscaping being put down.
It's gonna take a little bit of time, but I'm telling you, once this is finished, it's gonna look amazing.
This is the shower. That's right, guys, there's a shower here, okay? This is the sink, and there's gonna be mirrors, and when you open this door, it's gonna be really interesting because we have one shower head here. It's gonna be like a disposable, like a shower head you could take off, and it's also gonna be like a fountain, so you can use yourself, you know, do whatever you want, shower. A bench all across here to sit down and do whatever, and then another shower head here. So you have two shower heads in one bathroom, one for Yannette, one for me. I think I want this one. So this one's for me, this one's for Yannette. I'm already figuring out exactly what I want. The problem that we have, that we're trying to figure out, is what we're gonna do. So as you walk out, this is the master bedroom. Hello, Dad. Hey, Vinny. This is the closet here, right? So this is a really huge closet, as you guys could see. Yannette wants the closet. She wants to have her own master closet the way she wants it to be set up. Vinny's gonna make her dream closet happen. I don't wanna be sharing a closet with her. So my dad and I actually came up with this idea of giving Yannette, or I came up with it, giving Yannette the closet, and then figuring out another place to put all my stuff. And that's where we came to the conclusion to use this room here as kind of like a room to put, you know, some of my clothes, put the shoes, put everything. I was thinking of using this closet as like my own closet, but I don't need to use this room as a room. And if we have guests over, you want to have them be able to have a closet. So that's the problem we have now. I can't come up with a solution. Dad, can you come up with a solution?
For what?
The closet situation.
Well, seeing that you don't want to share any closet space with your nip because of your own crazy reasons, and you're not going to be in there at all, I would just hang your stuff in that closet. And it's fine. It's only a few feet away. And this way you've got everything separated.
That sounds like the best scenario of what we should do.
And keep it as a guest room. Don't set it up as like a shoe room. That's ridiculous.
But we want to know what you guys think. Should it be a shoe room? Should it be a guest room? All your comments, all your opinions, leave it here. And I'm going to read a lot of them because I'm still trying to figure out what I want to do. And my goal is, once we have the house finished and once the contract is finished and the mortgage is a go and we move into the house, I want to be having a plan to have the furniture. I want to order the furniture, order everything before we move in, so that it's here the day that we move in, so we can set it all up and have the house done as soon as possible. Dad, come over to the office real quick.
Okay.
I'm gonna show them the best room in the house.
Awesome.
So you walk over to here, lead the way, Dad. Just cause it looks cool when you have a person in front of you. Dad, you gotta shave that mullet off your head.
It's not a mullet.
I don't think I showed you guys this. You look like Billy Ray Cyrus. Cool. This is where the washer and dryer is gonna be, on top of each other. And then there's gonna be a sink here, and then I guess like another area over here. And this is the coolest room in the house, guys. My office. Dad, you gotta back up and show them the bathroom first.
Yeah, so chill. Oh, you want me to do it?
Yeah.
All right, so here, we came up with this idea with Vinny of, because he's gonna be in his office all the time, rather than go all the way halfway across the house to use the bathroom if he's working, we suggested if he could squeeze a half bath in here. And to give him another storage closet, a storage area, this is what Vinny came up with, and take a look.
And Vinny did it, because he's a man.
So take a look, tell us what you think. A little dark though, but.
Yeah, it's dark and you can't really see much yet, but this is gonna be like a bathroom here. It's like a little half bathroom, nothing crazy, but enough to get the job done. And then a little closet here to put like your lighting, camera equipment, tripods, etc.
Shoes. It's
everything. I guess you could put shoes here, but it literally has just enough space for everything you need for camera equipment, because when you turn this corner, this is gonna be the office.
This is gonna be the office in the studio, which is awesome.
This is the room here, guys. TV on this wall. Computer setup, gaming setup, everything. Possibly, most likely, putting a pool table over here. And
bar, you can put over the corner if you want.
Could put the bar over the corner too. There's a lot of options we could do with this too. I don't know what I'm gonna do with all this space over here, Dad. Do you have any ideas?
Actually, believe it or not, have custom racks built and put all your shoes there.
That's actually a really good idea.
That's pretty smart, aren't I?
I'm not lying. That's
a
that's a fantastic idea. Just put everything across over here.
Just against across the one wall.
That could actually work. Let me see.
Do some funky lighting to light them up.
You serious?
Yeah, why not?
That's actually not bad.
There you go.
I like that. But this is everything,
not
guys.
Not only looks, but brains too.
Yeah, but you gotta cut this hair off, though.
Yeah, I'm donating it. Yeah. Science.
Yeah, okay, Dad. Alrighty, guys. We're leaving the house now. Got Papa Sensor over here.
What's up?
And me over here and the house in the background. It's amazing. Anything you want to say, Dad?
Yep. Proud of my son. He's doing a terrific job. Love the work that Vinny's doing. The house is going to be beautiful. Hopefully, maybe a little luck, he could be in by August 1st and we could jump in the pool, which would be great. I want to spoil his pool.
Yeah, so so we got a lot of cool plans set up. If you guys do want to see more videos like this, let me know. I know you guys love watching the house update videos, and I love making them. It's like the highlight of my week is whenever I coordinate with Vinny to come out here, go to the down with my father, and record this. And it's amazing, guys. It's seriously amazing. It's a dream come true. And I'm going to keep giving you guys updates along the way. The paint is going to be done soon. The spackle's going to be done, then the paint's going to be done. Then they're going to do the trimming, the tile.
I'm thinking 2 more weeks we'll come back. Let's give them a chance to do some work. This way you'll see a big difference.
So you guys
can
see like a big difference. I don't want to just bring you guys here every single time when there's not much differences. But last time, you saw that the front was a lot different. Now the actual house has figures and models around with the sheetrock. Now when the tile and the trimming's done, and when the appliances start coming in, and everything's coming along together, you guys are gonna see
pool,
how crazy.
Pool house.
Well, that's gonna be the last thing is the pool house, the fencing, and the landscaping. But that's what's really gonna be the icing on the cake.
And the stupid fountain.
Why do you hate on my fountain, Dad?
I just don't like fountains.
Fountains are so cool. I love it.
Fountains belong at the park in Central Park, not on your front lawn.
Fountains are dope. I love it. I love it so much.
I love that so much.
Just have a bunch of pigeons coming over.
All right, guys, let's get out of here. All right, guys, so I'm back at the house now, and I am just so excited to move into this new place. I want to give a huge thank you to all you guys who sat through the whole video and watched this, and please give me your comments. Please give me your opinions. Obviously, it's my home. It's going to be my decision, but I want this to feel like it's also your decision as well, because you're the reason why I'm getting this house, and you guys are being along every step of the way with me as I'm doing this entire process. So again, thank you guys so much for watching. Please leave a like on the video, smash the thumbs up button. Smash the thumbs up button for some white shorts, some triple white Yeezys. They fire though. Thank you guys again so much for watching. I hope you guys all have a great day. It's been your boy Doug Sensormarin, and I'm out, guys. Peace.